Hello, I'm Angela, and welcome back to my channel, Literature Science Alliance, and today we're going to do a special video. So on this channel, I typically talk about books I like, why I like them, why I don't like them, or I sometimes do my Science Behind the Magic series, where I talk about the science behind things in fantasy and sci-fi books, things that I arbitrarily pick out, or times when authors are really inspired by real-life science that I want to share with you guys. But today we're going to talk about my science, what I do in the lab. And if you didn't know, I am a PhD student. I am currently pursuing a PhD in biophysics here in Boston, which means I've been doing that for 5 or 6 years. And I thought it would be cool to just talk to you guys about what I do in the lab, why I do it, what I think's cool about my project. And so here we go. So firstly, PhD in biophysics. What does that mean? Well, there's a lot you can do in biophysics. It's the integration of biology and physics. I have a background in physics, but specifically I focus on structural biology. And the idea behind structural biology is trying to answer biological questions by looking at the structure of the different things in our bodies. And what I mean by things is there are these machines, these little parts of our body that work to keep us functioning, and they are typically proteins. Proteins are what make you work. It's not just what you need to eat when you're like getting chicken or if you're getting tofu. Protein is so important in your body. How you work is based off these machines, and when they don't work, it's a problem, or when they're working too much. And part of how we ask questions is we want to know, how is something working? Is it overactive? Is it underactive? And part of that is through structure. The idea being, if you know how something looks, you maybe can figure out how it works, and then you can tweak it to work better or worse. And this is something pharmaceutical companies really focus on. But from a pure, just like inquisitive science perspective, if you want to know how something works, you look into it, right? You know, if you want to know why your car's not working, you open the hood, you look at the machine, and you figure out what is making it work or not work. And that's kind of the idea behind structural biology, is you're really just, we want to look at it. We want to see how it is. We don't just want to see how it works, we want to know why it works, and that's how we choose to approach that question. And the physics part of it is that these things are really small, like very small. You can't just use a standard light microscope. So you have to use techniques that were first developed in physics fields to answer these questions. So there are things like x-rays that we could use to determine structure, and what I use is cryo-electron microscopy, which is as cool as it sounds. It's this electron beam in a cryogenic state that interacts with the protein, and from this interaction, this diffraction, which we're not gonna go into diffraction, so don't be scared by that word, but that interaction of that electron beam with the electron density of our protein can tell us how it looks. And it works pretty well when you have a good sample. There's definitely a lot of pitfalls. None of this is easy science, but it's incredibly cool when it works. So that's structural biology and why I do it. I think it's really cool knowing how these small machines that make us work, how they look. Now, what's the biological question that I've been trying to answer? So it's related to heart disease, which is one of the major killers in the world. And heart disease, specifically the type where you have your blood vessels that are getting restricted, so atherosclerosis, that's related to cholesterol. So there's, I'm sure you've heard from the doctor, good cholesterol and bad cholesterol. They're kind of misnomers. It's a very complicated system. Nothing in biology is simple. But I study the good cholesterol, which is called HDL. And so if you ever have cholesterol blood work done, you know, you'll notice your doctor is always caring about that ratio. You might have high cholesterol, but if you have a high amount of HDL, they're less concerned than if you have a lot of the bad cholesterol, which is LDL. And so in the field, it's known that HDL is associated with a healthier heart, like I said, with that ratio. And we have the question, how is this good cholesterol made? And so previously in the lab, they've worked and they have studied the structure of a protein that is primarily found on these particles. These particles are like little spheres of fat and cholesterol that travel through your body. But if you have ever done dishes or anything with fat, know that fat and water don't mix well together. So what allows these fat particles to move through the body are basically these major proteins that encase them. And the one in this case is called ApoA1. And this is something my lab has studied forever, and they actually have discovered the structure of it. If you look at it, it kind of has like my ringlets of my hair. That's called an alpha helix structure. So that was a really big deal, but that's only part of the story. My part of the story is that that protein, that little belt that goes around the particles, the way it makes those particles is through an interaction with an alphabet soup protein called ABCA1. And this is different from ApoA1, which is in solution, as we call it. It's not attached to anything. Mine is a membrane protein. It is found on the membranes of cells, which cells always have these barriers, always have membranes. That's how you have more than one cell, right? That everything's not one big blob. And this membrane protein in particular pumps lipids from one side to the other. And when I say lipids, I mean fat. It literally pumps fat from inside the cell to outside the cell. And in doing that, somehow interacts with ApoA1 to form these tiny little cholesterol balls. We don't know how that works, but we're hoping to figure that out through structure. There is currently one structure that I'll show you guys so you can see what it looks like. Again, this is another thing that seems to be just made up of hair ringlets and everything like that. And what I'm hoping to do is, like most machines, it has an active state and an inactive state. And right now, we have this state, which is, we're unsure which one it is. So we want to figure out, what does it look like when it's active? What does it look like when it's inactive? And can we figure out how these two things interact? Do they actually bind to each other? Is it like a docking site? Like, you know, a ship comes into port, gets loaded up, and then leaves? Is it something else? We don't know, but we're hoping to answer it via structure. And that is, in a nutshell, what I do in the lab. Feel free to ask me any and all questions in the comments down below. I will be happy to answer them. Like, if you want to know the specific techniques I use and everything like that, because I just wanted this to be a broad overview of the project, you know, what I'm doing, why I'm doing it. And if you just want to leave me an emoji to let me know you're here, just leave me one of those weird sciencey ones that we always have. Like, there's like a flask, or I think there is like a scientist emoji. And otherwise, like if you liked it, subscribe if you want to, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.